once again. This is Momita.
Hey, hi, this is Subhajit here, and today in this video we would like to present you some of the key points what we have taken while staying here for a long duration. So when someone visits Singapore, they visit as a tourist most of the time, and they hardly get to know how this city functions. So this is one of the top most visited country. So we will try to put those points why somebody call it as one of the best places to stay here.
And we have tried a different approach in this video to tell you some facts about Singapore. I hope you will like it. And so come along with us and get an insider view of the Lion City.
On 23rd April 2016, I landed at Changi Airport without any idea how this small island would treat me. Yes, Singapore has breathtakingly beautiful and various tourist attractions, but what about daily life? With time, this city assured me to take a deep breath, relax, and not jump to any conclusion right away. So how did Singapore win my heart eventually? Number 1. Cleanliness is second nature. As the cab dashed me from the airport to our apartment, I was super impressed to see the neat and clean footpaths. Green-colored dustbins stood at regular intervals, and as a soothing change to my eyes, people actually care to use them. Cleanliness is as normal as breathing for people living on this island. I even saw pet owners bringing out plastic packets from their bags and lifting the poop of their beloved pets from the park. Of course, the necessity of keeping the environment clean and green did not dawn on Singaporeans overnight. The Lion City achieved this remarkable level of cleanliness with the help of responsible citizens and strict government rules. Number 2. Incredible neighbors. One fine morning, I found a stick note on our door from my ever-smiling neighbor. She was on a month-long vacation with her family and had a small request for us. Would we care to water her plants till she was back? No big deal, I thought. But what surprised me was her offer to pay us $50 in return for our favor. Offering money to neighbors for a small favor like this was a cultural shock for me. But then I realized this transaction-based relationship with neighbors was okay here. However, when she was back home the next month, I refused to take any money from her. And I had a tough time convincing her that we didn't expect anything in return from her for watering some water into her plant pots. But she returned with a box full of Royce chocolates the following evening, and I had to accept her gift this time. Another woman shifted to the same unit 2 months back, before posting this video. They had planned some interior decoration work in her house, and the drilling work would make unbearable noise. With goodie bags that contained a personalized apology note and 2 bag cans of wafers, I saw her going door to door and sincerely apologizing to her new neighbors for the inconvenience they would face. People here were considerate about my time, took care of any inconvenience I might face because of their actions, and most importantly, respected my privacy. What more did I need to form a special bond with a new place? Number 3. Maintain health free of cost. Unless you live in a housing society, the chances of getting access to gyms or parks for free in India are limited. But why am I even using the word free here? You have to pay a certain amount to become eligible to even push the gym store in your clubhouse. But Singapore ensures that every HDB building can access the nearest outdoor fitness zone and play zone for kids, and that too for free. Senior citizens can exercise in the parks. Few parks even have the provision for differently abled kids in the playground. Now that is quite thoughtful. So if you want to build your health without spending a single dollar, you know which places to keep an eye on in Singapore. Moreover, they have kept their footpaths broad and equipped enough to accommodate joggers, cyclists and pedestrians at one go. The only task for you is to jerk your lazy bones and step out of the house. Number 4. A heaven for women. Speaking of outdoor fitness zones, reminds me of another wonderful thing I have experienced in Singapore so far, and that is safety, especially for women. Initially, women going out for a jog at midnight used to surprise me. Standing near the bedroom window, I used to wonder what made them so fearless. As I started going out for evening strolls, I understood the reason behind their confidence. On several occasions, I went out for evening walks and returned home past 9 p.m. With earphones stuck into my ears, I strolled on the footpath with no street lights. With a group of men standing beside me, I had waited for the traffic signal to turn green, but I never sensed any pair of eyes hovering over me. Men, for some reason, know how to behave here, at least in public. Else they know a rigorous punishment awaits them in prison, accompanied by caning, and the caning count varies depending on the severity of the molestation charges. Number 5. 24/7 open stores. Until I arrived in this foreign land, my idea of a 24/7 open store was limited to pharmacies. But now, Prime, FairPrice, Giant, Cold Storage and Shenxiong are some of the names that come to my mind whenever I think of the term 24/7 open. There is no need to worry even if you run out of groceries at night and need to prepare something for dinner. Visit any of the mentioned stores and you can return with a bag full of groceries. Are you having those odd midnight cravings for ice creams? Walk to the store and grab your favorite flavor. Such 24/7 open stores have several branches all over Singapore. One is just on the other side of the road from where we stay and provide relief for those who like to shop at their own convenient pace and time. Number 6. Effective communication system. One of the best facilities that Singapore offers is its communication system. MRTs, that is Mass Rapid Transit, buses including the double deckers and taxis have made the entire communication network quite effective. Owning a private vehicle in Singapore will keep your pockets on constant fire, so people mostly rely on public transportation and the most popular mode of transport is MRT. Unless there is some maintenance work going on, trains are always on time. If you miss one train, the other one is only a few minutes away. Mobile apps are available for download to suggest which route you should take to reach your destination. All the public transports are clean and air-conditioned and expect its passengers to have proper etiquettes while traveling. So swipe your Easy Link card inside the metro station or on a bus and reach your destination. Number 7. Rule-abiding citizens. Singaporeans are very warm, soft-spoken, disciplined and honest in nature. They respect your privacy and expect you to do the same in return, and they have zero tolerance for any nonsense. when it comes to following rules and regulations, this country is pretty much serious. A rule is a rule, and nobody is above that. They have installed surveillance cameras throughout the island, and doing anything stupid will lead you behind bars with a hefty fine. During the circuit breaker period, that is lockdowns, many people have served sentences in prison or were fined just because they broke the stay-home notices or did not wear masks while stepping out. Singapore became a first world nation from a third world one in a short time, and it happened because of everyone's hard work and disciplined life. Anything that disrupts its pace is unacceptable. Number 8. Thoughtfulness. Providing a facility just for the sake of giving it is one thing. On the other hand, doing something keeping the real needs of the people around in mind is another. You will find a wonderful thought process working behind everything Singapore does. You can see free packets at the entrance of shopping malls on a rainy day, so that you don't enter the mall with a dripping umbrella and make the floor slippery. The floor on the playgrounds is made of rubber, so that kids don't get hurt while playing. Each household received a dedicated number of COVID ART test kits, masks, and oximeter during the pandemic. Public transports have provisions for those bound in wheelchair. All these small yet conscious and thoughtful efforts make lives better in this lion city. The extraordinariness of Singapore lies in its dedicated mindset and not taking anything for granted. They have worked hard to reach where they are today, and yet they have not forgotten their past filled with struggles. Thank you, Singapore, for extending your love and warmth and making me feel at home.
So that's it for today. So what's your opinion about Singapore? Did you like the animated representation of the Lion City? Will you prefer to see more such videos in future?
Yeah, so let us know your thoughts in the comment section. And please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. And thanks for watching.
Thank you so much.